So hello everyone, thank you so much for joining in today on IDP India Facebook page. And today we have Siddharth with us live from Birmingham for sharing his experience. Hi Siddharth.
Hi Anurag. I'm doing fine. How are you?
All good. And we are very glad to have you here virtually. And thank you so much for taking out time today to share your experiences. And I think like during this conversation, we'll talk on various important points. And it should help to international students while they are planning to study in coming intakes. So for the benefit of audience understanding, I just want to tell all of you, Siddharth is studying international relations and economics at University of Birmingham. And he traveled on 7th of September last month, and he has already completed his quarantine period. And I was chatting with him. He has visited the campus as well, and he has a lot of things to share it. So let me begin with one very primary question, Siddharth. And I think like it will come across always. What makes UK as a prominent study destination? Because when you started researching, I'm sure that you must be having a lot of options to consider from different countries. So if I talk about UK, what were your reasons to go to UK to study?
Well, actually I had the choice of going either to the US or the UK. And the reason I chose the UK was mostly because I felt it was better suited towards like economics and social science as well. And I felt that I would fit in with the culture a bit more. And that's mostly why I chose the UK. And it's like 3 years instead of 4 years. So I get 1 year less.
Okay. So how much time it took to do that research, that which country you are finalizing between US and UK?
It took me a couple months because it was a very serious discussion, because I thought I was going to go to the US for a long time, but then I decided the UK. So I needed to make sure everything was 100% correct to come to the UK then. It was a lot of research, but then like IDP helped clear it up a bit as to like how the process works in the UK, what are the courses and stuff.
And I'm sure that in this current challenging time or the new normal, it was not easy to take a call like you finally want to go abroad to study. So what was the motivation? What was the exact motivation?
I think I always figured that I would go abroad to study. And I understand that the situation is really different compared to previous years, but I just knew it was something that had to be done. And honestly, now coming to the UK and staying in Birmingham, they do take enough regulation and you don't feel like there's corona everywhere. It feels like everything is functioning normally. So it doesn't feel that different, honestly.
That's very good to know and very reassuring. Coming to the one interesting question, because I have a list of questions to talk. How was your experience when you started your journey from here to UK? If we talk about traveling journey, and any challenges which you have seen, or you any tips you want to give to international students while they are finalizing their final bid for travel?
Traveling wise, like, you do need to take precautions, but it's not as serious as you think it is. Normally the airlines, like the airlines I chose as well, British Airways, they do a good job and you don't need to worry. They provide you with a face mask, like the face shield, the mask. They give you hand sanitizer as well. And they take a lot of precaution. So you, although yes, as a responsible citizen, you have to take precaution yourself. Right. But you do not need to be as scared as what many people assume you have to be.
That's very interesting and interesting to know. Considering that a lot of universities right now providing opportunity for airport pickup after reaching to UK, airport pickup and all other arrangement. So it would be interesting to know that how you manage your journey from airport to your final accommodation at Birmingham. And any learning out of it, or any key points you want to share here now?
So my university offered to pick me up by shuttle either from London or from Birmingham. So I decided to get picked up from London. And actually what happened along the way was I went to the wrong terminal because the Heathrow Airport is really big. But then luckily I just called them and then they told me where to go correctly. Okay. And then there was already a bunch of students waiting there, like from different parts of the world. Yeah. And then yeah, we just took the shuttle, and from London to Birmingham, it's around 2.5 hours. So like during that time, I spoke to everyone on the bus also. So even before I reached the university, I made like 2 or 3 friends.
That's what we were discussing, like having friends in this time is very, very important. Yes. One question which we want to understand overall, like how you are finding your experience, a month experience in UK, overall environment, and how you want to describe it?
I felt it's been pretty fun, actually. Like, I've made a lot of friends. I've gone out with people. Like, we've gone out to the city. I've been to the campus. Then I have an amazing view of the lake right opposite to my building. So I feel it's pretty nice. And even though I don't have a lot of Indian friends currently, like I have, but most of my friends are from the European Union. And I don't feel that cultural difference, actually, where I don't feel left out from anything. We all have a good time regardless. And it's been pretty fun. Yeah.
That's good. And so as we understand, considering the social distancing norms in place, a lot of universities are offering hybrid learning as well.
Yeah.
So what is your experience when it comes to hybrid learning, or you must be attending a lot of classes online when you are in your accommodation? So how's that? Yeah. How easy or how tough it is to cope up with the studies, or what is the experience altogether?
Yeah, so the way it works in Birmingham, like University of Birmingham, is we get a weekly schedule. So at the beginning of each week, they publish all the work we have to do, where I would say 50% is self-learning and the other 50% is online. So I don't actually have that many classes online. So I'll have like maximum 2 or 3 classes online, and the rest I have to study on my own. And I've been managing. Like, there was some technical difficulties in the beginning, and there still are now. But as long as you know which class to attend, you don't really miss out on anything. And it doesn't feel like you're losing a lot of learning. But then what Birmingham is doing now is, starting from next week, you're allowed to attend some of the classes in the campus. So you have to sign up for that. So every alternate week, you'll have 2 classes in the campus and then 2 classes on Zoom.
Okay. And another question is coming in my mind. After knowing that you got a chance to visit your campus multiple times, how was your first expression or the reaction when you visited your campus? I hope you liked the campus and the place.
Yeah, the campus is actually really amazing because they have like this clock tower in the middle of it. And if you go at night, it lights up. So it looks really beautiful. And the first time I went to collect my BRP card, which is a biometric report. And that's like that's like your proof that you live in the UK. So I believe all international students have to collect that.
They have to, yes.
So I would say, it was pretty, like, they follow the social distancing and everything very well. Like, you know the social distancing's in place, but you don't actually feel it because everyone's still doing their own thing. It's like, you don't see everyone purposely trying to, you know, stay far away and all, but like, you know, they're wearing their mask, they have the hand sanitizer, they're doing their own thing, and that's pretty much it. You don't feel the rules pressed down on you.
Glad to know that. And coming to some last part of the questions today and the discussion points, actually, I would say, how was your experience altogether with IDP? If you talk about your journey with IDP and I believe you came from IDP Bangalore.
Yes.
So how was your overall journey, and what do you want to say on that?
So my counselor, her name is Minnie Menon, and IDP and her, they were like very helpful because, like I told, I decided to come to the UK towards the end. So I didn't understand the process that well. And I just knew which university I wanted to go to, which course. But she helped me through the process. She told me what information I need to bring. She helped me fill it out. Then she gave me recommendations on what to do again. Then she helped me with the visa documents, which ones to collect. Because according to me, that's the most difficult part, collecting all the correct documents for the visa. And she helped me with that. And then she actually helped me get a scholarship as well. So I got a scholarship for £5,000. And yeah, it was just, it's like, IDP and Mini Ma'am, they were like always there 24/7 to like constantly helped me out with any doubt, no matter how small it was. They're constantly there. And even Mini-Ma'am now, if I ask her something, she will respond. It's not like after I came to university, it was over.
So this is something like, we are very happy to know that you are happy with the services given by IDP. And that is what is our motive. And we'll continue to do that services to all the students who are aspiring to study in UK or any other country to best to our ability. And last question, which is like a message from you to international students who are planning to come to UK, maybe in coming up January 2021 intake. So what are the things like, what are the top 3 or 5 tips from your side to any international student who are planning to study in UK?
I would say it's not as scary as you think it is. Like COVID is a very big thing. It is a pandemic, but when you come here, as long as you follow the social distancing yourself, that's basically more than enough. You're not going to feel that difference where you have rules imposed on you. But everyone does follow the rules, but like you don't feel it. So you're not going to miss out on anything by waiting an entire year or something. Like I'm coming now and I feel I've gained a lot of experience, and that's with COVID here. But I don't feel like I've missed out on anything. And I would say that for anyone else who comes. So as long as you're responsible, you're not going to miss out on anything. But I would say...
I think you mentioned one of very, very important point. There is an opportunity cost for everything, that if you miss on whole year, that is not something very good to do. As you said, like you are there, you are happy with the things and you are learning. So I think learning should not be stopped.
Yeah.
Right. And you were mentioning some more points. Please carry on. Yeah.
I would say though, it's important to make friends though, because if I didn't make friends during my isolation time, I think it would have been very different for me.
Yeah.
And I made sure to, my friends were like, I made sure to branch out a lot, because normally I find it very difficult to socialize in general, but then I kind of pushed myself to do that. And I made sure my friends were like from different cultures as well. Like I wanted to make sure they were from like different backgrounds, like countries, because it's just like a new fresh perspective. Like even if at the beginning I didn't understand a lot of like the culture, but now I do a lot, and like I feel a lot more informed. And once you have a decent number of friends, then like the experience becomes so much better, because you're not by yourself anymore. You have a group of people as well.
Right. That's very well said. Thank you so much, Siddharth, for taking out time today. And we really enjoyed talking to you, because getting the perspective life from Birmingham and from the place where a student aspiring to go, I think it is going to help students while they are making their minds and deciding further. So thank you so much for taking out time again, and all the very best for your studies and your stay in UK. Keep in touch and stay safe.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you for having me. Bye.
Bye-bye.